My dear students, how are you all? Hope that you all are fine and doing well at home. I'm your English teacher, Miss Iram Naz, and today we are here to learn about English. So let us start our today's lecture. In our today's lecture, we will do our school workbook page number 21, 22, and 23. Kindly open your English school workbook. This is the picture of your English school workbook. Let us start. English school workbook page number 21. On page number 21, you can see that it's written unit number 3. Androcles and the Lion. Do you remember the story of Androcles and the Lion? Yes, this is the same story that we have done already. So what you have to do, now you have to do the question answers of this unit. Now you have to read the question very carefully. Make sure that you understand the question properly. There are two things that you have to remember. First, that one word answer is not acceptable, and you have to write the full answer as told in the lecture, like the way I'm telling you about. So let us start. Answer these questions. Who was Androcles? Who was Androcles? Androcles kaun tha? Do you remember who was Androcles? Yes. Now you have to write the full answer. You will not write one word answer like a slave or just slave. You will write he was a slave, or Androcles was a slave. And you have to remember the punctuation rules also, that the first letter is capital and you end with a full stop. Now let's come to question number 2. What was in the lion's paw? What was in the lion's paw? Ke sher ke panje mein kya cheez thi? What? Kya cheez thi? Excellent, very good. It was a thorn. Very good. So you will not write a thorn only one word answer. No, you have to write the full answer. There was a thorn in the lion's paw, in this line, and make sure that you start with a capital and you end with a full stop. Next, question number 3. Where did Androcles meet the lion? Where did Androcles meet the lion? Do you remember? No, it's not in the desert. In the desert, he ran and ran, and then he went to a specific place. What was that area? What was that place called? That place was called cave. Very good. So what you will do, where did Androcles meet the lion? He met the lion in the cave, or Androcles met the lion in the cave. Very good. Now turn your pages. Number 22. So what is on page number 22? On page number 22, you can see word opposites. Yes, it's the same word opposite that we have already done. So you have to remember two rules. Rule number 1, nouns has no opposites. Noun has no opposites. And rule number 2, adjective, that is describe that those words that describes a noun has opposites. Okay, you have to remember these two rules very carefully and make sure that you don't forget it. So let us start. Word opposites. Look through the list of words given in the box, underline the words that have opposites, and write down the opposite next to them. So I will do only this one line for you, and then the next will be done by yourself. You have to read the word carefully, and you have to think that either it's a noun or it's an adjective. So let us start. New. Is new a noun? No, new is not a noun. New is an adjective. So you will underline it like this and write over here. What is the opposite of new? It's old. O L D old. Very good. You will write it like this. Next, we will do the next word is black. What will come in black? Is black a noun? No, it's not a noun. It's an adjective. So what is the opposite of black? It's white. Very good. So you will write very neatly W H I T E. My apologies for the writing. Because I'm writing on computer, that is the reason my writing is not very neat. So please forgive me for that. But you have to write very, very neatly. So now the next word is table. Is table a noun or an adjective? Table is a non-living thing. Yes. So what you will do for nouns, you will put a cross like this. Okay. So make sure that you do this page very carefully and very neatly. Number 23. On page number 23, it's the AND word. Do you remember the AND word? Yes. And do you remember its rules? Excellent. What was the rule number one? It is used to join same sentences. And the rule number two was it is used in between two naming words. Yani two nouns ke beech mein ye AND bhi aata hai, so that it can make a sensible sentence. This is the picture of page number 23. Let us start joining words. Rewrite the sentences below, putting in AND wherever needed. Example, the teacher said, put your books, pencils in your bag. Put your books, pencils in your bag. As you can see, there are two nouns over here. One and two. But is it making a sensible sentence? No. So what you will do, you will rewrite the sentence again. The teacher said, put your books and pencils into your bag. Very good. Excellent. Do you remember these sentences? These are the same sentences that you have done in your Broadway course book. Yes, these are the same sentences. So this is just a practice for those sentences, and you have to do it very carefully. So let's take a quick wrap up. What we did today in our school workbook, we did page number 21. Those were the question answers of Androcles and the Lion. Next, we did page number 22, which were word opposites. And on page number 23, we did the joining word and. Don't forget to like, subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming videos. I am Miss Iramna signing off. Thank you so much for listening to my lecture. And if there is any problem, do contact us. Allah Hafiz.